Hello everyone, welcome to today's cooking session. So today I am going to show you four recipes in the next half an hour which are very easy to prepare, and the ingredients are also very easy to find, and most of the things you'll get at your home only. Maybe a few things you have to buy from outside, but I think everyone should know a bit of cooking. In the lockdown time, I think a lot of people have started cooking at home because they don't have their household mates coming to their places, so everybody is cooking at home. And very few people are ordering from outside or going out to eat in the restaurants as well. So I think in times to come, all of us need to know a little bit of cooking. Don't you think so? So today, we are going to do four recipes as I told you. The first one is a very interesting breakfast item, which is like egg, which is like a pasta, egg pasta. Okay, when you go through the recipe, you will understand what I mean by egg pasta. So egg pasta on toast is number one. Number two is I'm doing a dessert with mangoes and chia, and we are going to make a mango chia pudding, which is also a very interesting dessert and very yummy. We are going to make a Maggi burger. You all guys must be eating Maggi at home, right? And everybody loves Maggi. But how about a Maggi burger? So we'll go do a Maggi burger today. And the last thing we are going to do is one very refreshing summer beverage which all of you would like, which is also called Sharbat-e-Mahabbat, which is available and in Jama Masjid. If you go, you will see people are selling Sharbat-e-Mahabbat on the roadside. But this is a recipe that you can do at home with very little ingredients, and it is a very nice hydrant during the summers, and it is also a very healthy drink. So let's go ahead with today's session and let's start off with the recipes. Hi, now I'm going to show you something very interesting, a very interesting breakfast recipe which is very creative at the same time, and you don't need too many ingredients for this. So you just need eggs and a beater to beat up the eggs. You need bell peppers, red, yellow, green, which will make it look colorful. Two slices of bread, some butter, salt, pepper, some oregano and chili flakes, right? And tomato ketchup to go with that. So you need a toaster to toast this bread, and you need a pan to make the omelets. So I'll show you how you can make egg pasta instead of making an omelet, and make it look like a pasta and make it look very interesting at the same time. So first thing, we need to break these eggs. So I'm making it with 4 eggs right now. If you have a bigger family, you can add more eggs to it. Just make sure no eggshell goes into the mix. So now what you need to do is whisk the eggs and beat them just to break the egg yolk and let it mix with the egg white. So beat it nicely so that it gets mixed nicely, and then you just add a little bit of pepper, black pepper, and a little bit of salt. Little bit of oregano and a little bit of chili flakes, and again mix it. So now the egg is ready. Now what we'll do is, now we will make very thin pancakes out of the eggs. Before that, we will cut these vegetables into thin strips. So this is a yellow bell pepper. So I just need to cut it a little bit from the sides, a little bit of the red, and a little bit of the green. So it'll be a nice colorful thing. So what I'll now do is cut fine strips of the green, red, and the yellow, just as it goes inside a pasta, and cut it slowly
you don't have to hurry up. So when you cut the vegetables, the knife is slanting outside, right? So it's at 45 degree angle outside of your fingers, these fingers. So there is no way you can cut your hands. So on the plate now we have all the bell peppers. I've also taken some corns because I love corns. You can also add mushrooms or chicken, whatever you like, maybe some sliced sausages and a little bit of fresh coriander, which I will use in a while, and I'm going to show you how to make it. So now we are making the pancakes. So I've taken a pan on the induction plate, and this is the egg mixture that we had beaten earlier, and I'm just going to add some butter on the pan first and melt some butter. So I've melted some butter in the pan, and I'm going to add that egg mix, a little bit of that, and just spread it around just to make a thin pancake like thing. And let it cook for a while. See, the egg is nicely getting cooked now, and you can see how colorful it's looking with the chili flakes and the oregano in it. Very thin pancake kind of omelette. And I've made around 4 of them out of the 4 eggs. And after this, the interesting part will start, making the pasta out of the egg. So the pancake is ready now. I'm going to just put it on the plate, topple it on this plate, and I'll make the next one. So now these eggs are ready, and I'm going to cut the roll out of it and make a pasta shape eggs like a ribbon. So I'm rolling these eggs. Now it's like a roll. And very carefully, I'll cut like a ribbon. Just like a ribbon shaped pasta. So now just open up the roll and see it becomes ribbon like a pasta. Like a tagliatelle pasta. So all the ingredients are here on this plate. We have this ribbon shaped eggs like the omelets. We have the bell peppers. I have taken some corns, which I love. You can add mushrooms or chicken or sausages, whatever you want. I have some chopped coriander. So now I'll toss everything together in a pan. So for the eggs, I'm going to now heat up the pan. Induction plate is on now. And while the egg will get prepared, I will make the toasts, because it's a breakfast item, and I've taken 2 slices of brown bread, which I'm going to toast here. The pan is hot now. I'm just putting some butter. And first thing, I'm going to toss these bell peppers. So the egg is already cooked. Little bit of corn and chopped coriander. Little bit of herbs and chili flakes. Chili flakes is an option if you like it spicy. And then toss it nicely so that the bell peppers get cooked a bit, and it should still remain crunchy. You should not overcook it. So when you are sauteing it, be careful you do not touch the pan. It's very hot inside. You have to be careful about that. This is fireless cooking. I'm using the induction plate, so there is no scope of any accidents, and it is perfectly safe. Now the bell peppers are nicely tossed in butter. I'm going to add the eggs to it. And then gently mix it and toss it. Along with the bell peppers. So it's almost done now. You just toss it for two minutes with the eggs, and now it's perfectly ready. Toasts are also ready, and we are ready to serve this wonderful looking breakfast dish, which everyone will enjoy. The toasts are ready now, nicely brown and crispy. So I'm just applying some butter. And now I'll cut it into halves, like in triangles. And now we'll arrange it on a plate. So arrange the toast nicely on a plate first. Nicely arrange it on the toast with a tong. And you can serve it with some ketchup. And you can just drizzle some ketchup on the side of the plate. And enjoy. I can add some corns or some garnish on top. And just enjoy your breakfast. So this is a nicely looking egg pasta which you, your parents, anybody can enjoy. You can adjust the spices or the chili flakes according to your like. You can add chicken to it, you can add sausages. And it's the perfect breakfast for you guys. So now we are going to prepare a very interesting dessert recipe which is very easy to make as well. It is, so mango is in season now, so you get abundance of mangoes in the market. Cream is available, this cream you get in any grocery shop. I have bought some chia seeds which is very healthy and this makes this dessert very interesting. So I have cream, I have sugar, I have puree of mango and then I have chia seeds and I have this dairy milk chocolate which I'll use later to garnish the dessert. And I have two of these glasses where I'm going to set the desserts. The first thing that we need to do is take out the puree. So you have to take out the mango in a mixie or a blender and take out the puree that I have already taken out in this bowl, you can see. The next step that we need to do is we have to whip cream, right? So I have some cream out here. I have taken two of these packets, some other dairy cream which you get everywhere you it is available in the market. And I have put two of these packets in this bowl. And now I'll add some sugar. Let's say around 5-6 tablespoons of sugar. Five of these tablespoons. And now start whipping it till it becomes fluffy and stiff. If I need more sugar, I will add some more sugar. Now look at this cream. Now it is nicely whipped and it is a little thick now with the sugar inside it. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to soak chia seeds in this cream. So I'll divide this cream into two parts. First half I'll use the chia seeds and the second half of the cream I'll add the mango puree. So the mango puree is here. It is already taken out. So this is also a thick liquid. So which will get mixed with the cream. So I'm putting the chia seeds in this bowl and I'm going to add half of this cream, whipped cream along with sugar and mix it with the chia seeds. And just leave it like that for maybe half an hour or 1 hour. It will become thick and nice. Chia seeds, as you know, is very healthy. So, and the balanced cream, I'm adding the mango puree and mixing it. Along with the cream. So I'm just going to put these two mixtures separately now and let it rest for some time. Both the chia seeds with the cream and the mango with the cream. Later on we will set it in this glass. So now we will set up the pudding. See, the mango is ready, all set, and chia seeds are also set. We are just going to dish it out now. There's some for garnish. I've kept some vanilla cigars and mango, chopped mango, and we'll grate some chocolate on top. So I had some dairy milk with me, so I'm using it. You can use Kit Kat or any other chocolate that you want. So let's get started for setting the pudding now. So look at the consistency of the chia, which is soaked. It was soaked in sweetened cream. So it's nicely, once you put it in the glass, and then keep it in the refrigerator, it'll set more. So I'm just going to pour the first layer of chia. Maybe half of it. And just shake the glass a bit so that it settles down properly. And the next layer of the glass I'll put with the mango. Because the mango is thinner than the chia, it'll set on the top of the chia. Whichever is the heavier will go at the bottom. So just to garnish, I'm just grating some chocolate here, which will go on top of the mango. It'll give a nice color contrast to it, as well as the chocolatey flavor with the mango and the chia will also come out very nice. So here is the mango chia pudding. I've set it in two glasses and there is still a lot of mango and chia left here, so you can set in other glasses for the other family members. But now I'm going to garnish the two. So I'm adding some chopped mangoes on top. Some fresh mangoes will really go nice with this. And I add some of the grated chocolate on top. And if you have these cigars, these are munchies, you can add whichever flavor, chocolate, strawberry, vanilla, just to make it look nice. So here are these two glasses, which are ready to serve now. So what you can do after this, you can put it back in the fridge, and in a couple of hours, it will become absolutely chilled and it's ready to serve. Enjoy this one. It's a nice, healthy mango chia pudding. Here we are with another very interesting recipe. Who doesn't love Maggi? Everybody loves Maggi, right? So we are doing a Maggi burger this time, because everybody loves burgers, everybody likes Maggi. So why not make a burger out of it? So here are the ingredients for Maggi burger. We have one packet of Maggi noodles. Then we have some chopped bell peppers, colorful bell peppers, which I have used earlier in my other recipe also. I have cheese slice here. So we'll use one cheese slice, and again oregano and chili flakes and butter, salt, pepper and some ketchup, and there's a burger bun. So first thing, we will prepare the Maggi, which takes 2 minutes, everybody knows, and I think a lot of you make Maggi at home. So making Maggi is not a tough thing, you just have to boil water and put the Maggi inside it and the powder, Maggi powder, taste maker inside it. So, as soon as the water turns to boil, we will add this Maggi inside. Maggi is one of my favorite dish, by the way. When I was in school also, I think I have made so many Maggis when in school and in college. And we made so many different things out of Maggi. We made Maggi pakoras also. So from the Maggi pakora only I got the idea of the Maggi burger. Is almost dried up now, and the Maggi is also a little overcooked than it should be, because you want it like that. So now we put the Maggi in a glass bowl and let it cool. Just spread it a bit so that it cools faster. So this will allow it to cool faster, and we will add some chopped vegetables inside the Maggi, but before that we will saute the vegetables as well. So these are the bell peppers we are going to saute now. So we have added some butter into the pan. We'll melt the butter and saute the chopped vegetables for the burger. We'll add some salt and pepper, some herbs and chili flakes. We'll not cook the bell peppers so much that it becomes soggy. The crunch has to remain in the bell peppers. So we just added a little bit of herbs and salt to it and toss it gently so that the crunch also remains and it becomes cooked also from the outside. It's not too raw. And now we'll add this to the Maggi mix. So yeah. And we'll allow both of them to cool together because we need to make a patty out of this now. So we will also add some grated cheese now to the Maggi mix, which will not only give a good taste to the burger patty, but it will also help in the binding of the patty because it has to hold together. So the cheese will help the patty to hold together and it will also give a delicious taste to the patty. So the Maggi powder, the Maggi seasoning powder, now we are adding to that. Instead of making, preparing the Maggi, generally we put the Maggi powder inside the water. But we will now put it here in the burger while we are making the burger mix, so that the taste remains fresh and we can get a better taste in the burger with the seasoning. So I'm adding a little bit more salt and pepper and a little bit of herbs. Now we mix it well with your hands. You can wear a gloves and mix it nicely. And you can mash it a bit because you need to, you know, make patty out of it. So you have to mash it a bit with your hands. So here is the cornstarch. I'm using this brand, Brown and Paulsen. So this is also available in any store around your place. So we need to add a bit of this into the mix so that it really binds well and doesn't fall apart when we're going to prepare the patty. That's it. So once the corn flour is added, we again mix it well with our hands. And now you can make these balls and then flatten it out a bit to give it the shape of the burger patty. See if it's holding together or not. If it doesn't, you can add a little bit more corn flour to it, or you can add a bit of cheese. So now it's time to prepare the Maggi burger. So this is what we have on the plate. We have those Maggi patties. We have one burger bun, one cheese slice, some slices of tomato, and we have butter. And this pan, in this pan, we are going to now shallow fry those patty. And before that, we will toast the burger bun a bit. We'll butter it, and then put it on the pan. And just let it toast a bit. So on both the buns we'll apply butter and toast a bit on the pan. Okay, now we are going to make the patty. So we are already heating some oil in this pan. We're going to shallow fry the patty, and before putting it on the pan, we are going to dust the patty with some corn flour on both sides so that it cooks well and doesn't get stick to the bottom of the pan also, and it gives a nice color also. We are not going to deep fry it, we are going to shallow fry it. So you can see how much oil is there, very less oil is there. And it is dusted with cornstarch. Now it will go inside the pan. Yeah. It should not be too hot, otherwise it will burn the patty. It should be in medium heat right now. The temperature is showing us 12. And let it cook in medium heat because it needs to get cooked from both sides and perfectly cooked. should not be raw from outside. It should be nice crunchy. In the meanwhile, Ankit has already put some mayonnaise in these two buns. Cheese slice is also ready, the tomato slices are ready. We can also add lettuce. Today I didn't have it, but generally I put lettuce also in my burgers. Some people like onions, and I don't like onions personally in my burgers, but some people like raw onions, and some people put sauteed onions in a burger, and caramelized onions sometimes. Oh yeah, but see, look at this. It is getting the golden crust because of the cornstarch. Looking yummy. See, it's nice and golden from both the sides now. So we will take it out from the pan and make the burger. So once you take it out, you can put it on a paper towel to drain the excess oil out of this burger. And then you put it on. Now we are going to arrange the burger. We will layer it up. First layer, we'll put the tomato slices. And after putting the tomato slices, we'll sprinkle some salt and pepper on the tomato. And after that, we'll put the patty on top. So after this, we put the slice of cheese. And then we'll take it to the microwave oven and melt the cheese. So yeah, we are melting the cheese now. A nice cheese melt on top of the Maggi burger will be yummy. So after looking at this burger, I felt like, you know, frying some nice masala fries, which really goes well with this burger. For that, you need to add a little bit more oil, and it's a frozen product you get in the market. It's a frozen product, it's just ready to fry. Just take it out from the packet, put it in the oil and fry it, and it's ready. So the fries are ready now, so I've strained the oil and just drained the excess oil from the fries. And here is the plate of burger. We can serve it with the fries now on the side. And we'll put some tomato ketchup in the dip bowl. And here we go, the Maggi burger. Delicious Maggi burger is ready. Yeah, looks good. Try it at home. I'm sure you will like it. Now this is Chef Ankit, who is going to prepare a very refreshing summer beverage for all of you, which is made out of watermelon and guava and milk. Little bit of ice cubes. It's a very refreshing summer drink. It rehydrates your body and it's a very healthy drink. So Ankit will go ahead with the drink right now.
Hello everyone.
So now Ankit is pouring some milk first in a jar. You can use any kind of milk, whether it any kind of brand. It can be Amul, it can be Nestle, it can be any other mother dairy. The milk should be chilled enough from beforehand, and then you add let's say around 4 or 5 tablespoon of roux afza. If you want sweeter, you can add more. So very simple drink to make, anyone can make it. The next thing that goes in is ice cubes. So once you stir the milk, you will get the pink, light pink color, and you can understand whether you need more roux or not. I think a lot of you already drink this kind of a milk, and roux is a very common thing, but something like watermelon in it is something little different. By the way, if you go to Jama Masjid, this is a very common drink and they call it Sharbat-e-Mohabbat. So I love this drink. Whenever I go to Jama Masjid, I have this drink. It is very refreshing. So Ankit has added some ice cubes to the milk and the roux afza to make it chilled. And He has nicely curved a watermelon shell. He has taken out everything out of the watermelon and cut dices of the same watermelon, which is going to add to the drink now. So once you have these bits of watermelon in the drink, and when it comes in your mouth when you're drinking, it is really refreshing and it gives you really wonderful taste. So once this is done, it's nicely mixed. You just have to pour this in this shell of watermelon which he has already curved out, and you can serve it in this watermelon shell itself, which really looks nice and pretty, and it's a nice party drink as well. And you just put the straws around and enjoy this drink. You can also pour it in small glasses and serve. So beverage, it's a very cooling drink and very healthy. You guys should try it.
So now that we have completed all the four recipes, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and each one of you will be trying something at home, I'm sure. Somebody will try the beverage, somebody will try the burger, somebody will try the breakfast egg pasta, somebody will try the dessert. And I'm sure your parents will also like it, appreciate it, and you can give a surprise at home by cooking something for them. Because all the time they're doing for you, now it's your turn to do something at home and make them happy. And I'm sure, because for your future also, when you go to hostel and you go abroad study, a little bit of cooking knowledge is very much required. And this will help you throughout your life. And not only cooking, we will also teach you in our next episode about the restaurant table etiquettes and napkin folding and stuff like that. So see you soon. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And Chef Ankit will also be there next time with me. Until then, goodbye. I really appreciate that your school has taken this initiative. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys.